Okay, so we're just gonna jump straight into it like usual. We're gonna do my brows, and so when I do my brows, I do them in a pointed upward direction because, once again, evil girl, evil eyebrows. Okay, so when I do my brows I try to make like an angry face, kind of. It helps get the lines together. And honestly, you know, if you don't do your brows like this, and if you don't like angry brows, skip this part. I'm just using like an eyebrow brush that I got from the beauty supply. And honestly, if you guys like, I just don't feel like putting it in the description right now, but if you need it, I will. So I'm just cleaning up my brows a bit with some concealer, making the lines extra pointy. So now I'm using my favorite foundation by Kat Von D, which is Good Apple. Good Apple foundation lasts all freaking day. Even when I'm in the hot sun, Good Apple never disappoints me. And I'm just using a brush and I'm just stippling that in because, you know, that's how you get it to get all up in your pores, which is a bad thing. But, you know, when I do my makeup, I'm doing it to last. You know, I'm truly doing it to last. So now I'm using my Tarte concealer stick, which is my favorite. Everyone knows this. It's my favorite. I try not to use it because it's expensive. I cannot afford all this damn makeup. Alright, so now I'm just pressing that in my skin. I do not use the beauty blender on this part because I want all the product to be there. Like, I want it all to be, you know, like, in place, you know. So I make sure I use a small brush just to pat it into the places and make sure it stays in these places. So I'm just, you know, highlighting the parts of my face that I want to be highlighted. And yeah, just blending that in all around. So for this look, I'm gonna have a short face, kind of. Betty Boop kind of has like a round, short face. So the chin contour is really important to this look because it makes your face shorter. So I'm just blending that in, and I'm using just a, excuse me, my voice is raspy, but I'm using a black opal foundation stick. And if you need these colors, I promise I will put them down, but you just have to comment and let me know. So, sorry. I don't know what's wrong with my voice. I've been doing bad stuff. But, so I'm blending it in with the beauty blender. So this is the only time I really use the beauty blender, is when I need it to be like towards the end, when I'm making sure everything can be blended in together. But while I'm doing it, I like to keep it in its own sections. But in the end, I'm using the beauty blender. Sorry if this voiceover sucks, because I'm like in the bed right now, super high and tired, and I just decided to finish this voiceover. So now I'm just blending it in with the beauty blender. And my beauty blender is wet, like a little damp, you know, just to get all the products moving good. And yeah, so we're just blending that in as much as you need. But make sure, honestly, it's better to over blend than to not, if that's even a thing. So now we're baking. I'm using my Makeup Forever, I forgot, banana powder, I guess. And I'm just putting it in the places where we put the highlighter. you know, so we can make sure those stay highlighted. And the forehead, so I have really oily skin, so my T-zone has to be baked. It has to be. There is no way. So I am just going ahead and lining my lips with this red lip liner I got at the beauty supply you know the beauty supply brand, guys. And I'm just lining that and filling it a little bit, but I'm gonna use this liquid lipstick on top of it because it just makes more sense to me to use that. And yes, I just cracked my back. Yeah, so we're using that. And now I am blending in my bronzer. So I use a deep, kind of like sun-kissed bronzer. And I'm just doing my forehead and all of the places where you put that dark contour. We're just going over that with the bronzer. You know, warming our face up. We don't want to look white and pale. It's summertime. We want to look tan and sun-kissed. So I'm putting that all over it. And now I'm just contouring my nose. I do a button nose, of course, because we love a button nose. And Betty Boop, she doesn't have any nose. So she's lucky I'm giving her one right now. And I'm going to use that same color I used on my contour. I'm going to use that over my eyes. Just as a nude, like, base. You know? Like a nude base. And then I'm going to take this white eyeshadow. I'm just going to put that in the, you know, not the crease, on the lid. And we're going to put that on the lid and kind of just blend it out. Blend it out as much as we can. And yeah, we're just blending that out. And we don't want it to be too white because, you know, that with the red to me is just a bit too harsh for me. So I blended it really good to the point where it just looks light. So now I'm just doing my cat eye. I'm doing a thick cat eye for this look because I want dramatic eyes. You know, Betty Boop is giving drama. So yeah, we're doing a dramatic cat eye today. So do that on both eyes. And make sure you bring it out, start at the very corner. And kind of don't really follow the shape of your eye. Make your own shape, you know? That's the thing with makeup. You can make your own face. You can change the way you look, you know? So, we are just going to do that and, you know, make a real dramatic wing upward. Clean it up in the corners. I think that looks great. So now we're gonna take our fiber mascara. Y'all know I love the fibers. And we're just gonna coat our lashes with that and do it in a downward motion because we're gonna be putting our lash glue on our eyeliner and we don't want that on our lashes. So make sure you brush them down because I have lashes that curl upward. So make sure you brush them down as best as you can and yeah, do them both like that. And I love this mascara. So now we're gonna put our clear eyelash glue on the line. On the line, directly on it. And once that dries, the lash will go on so easily. And these are my favorite lashes from Shine. Remember, you guys, I told you about these. I will put the link if you comment. I will link everything. So now they're both on. They're giving spider, like Betty Boop spider lashes. So now we're just going to pat in our powder that we use to bake. We don't waste product. We pat it in. We don't brush it off to the side. We press it into our skin. So I'm pressing it in and, you know, making sure it's going the places that I need it to. Now I'm taking this hot pink blush and I am just going along my cheeks. I have a round face, so I go in an upward manner. I have a heart-shaped face, so I go with the shape of how my cheeks go upward, and I kind of, you know, put it under my eye. So now I'm drawing my Betty Boop bottom lashes on with my liquid liner. And we're doing dramatic ones, so we want them to be long. And now I'm taking my fiber mascara that I love and just going over those lines that I made. Well, I'm just using mascara on my bottom, but it looks really good over those lines we already made. So yeah, putting, you know, just adding a little bit of extra touches. And I'm putting a lot of coats because, as we know, Betty Boop has some caked on lashes, child. So we're gonna cake it up. Okay, as you can see, I did like literally three coats of this. So now I'm just doing my highlight. I've already sprayed my setting spray. I'm highlighting very subtly because, you know, I don't want to be too dramatic. And this is the finished look. If you want the install to this wig, it's Bobbi Boss Milo wig in color 1B. I have uploaded the install video, so go check that out if you want the full tea on this look. But right here, I am just doing the finishing touches on the wig, flattening it up with my hot comb. And, you know, just laying it, making sure it doesn't look too wiggy. And I really like this wig. It's a synthetic wig, but the lace is really good. The hair is good. It's perfect for the summer. It's like a summer bob. And here we go. The finished modern day Betty Boop baddie black girl look. And like I said, if you want to see the install video, subscribe.